Hey everyone, my name is Mandy Gladden, and I was invited to this group to talk to you guys today about winged eyeliner and how to do it. As you can see, I don't have any eyeliner on right now, I don't have any mascara on right now, my eyes feel very naked. Even though they've got my eyeshadow on, I don't feel right. I feel like I look ill if I don't have at least mascara on. And eyeliner is super important to me. I really like eyeliner, so we're gonna talk about that. I'll wait a couple minutes, see if a couple of you hop on here. If you're watching this on the replay, no problem, but if you're coming on live or you're watching on the replay, just say hello or drop me an emoji below if you like this kind of thing, or if you have trouble doing eyeliner or winged eyeliner, hopefully I can teach you some tips. Okay. So, winged eyeliner. It can be frustrating. It can be very frustrating. And I don't really know if anyone ever becomes like a perfected pro at it. I mean, we're always gonna like mess things up here and there. But if you take some time and you practice it, you'll get really good at it. I promise, I promise, I promise. Okay, so winged eyeliner. How do we do it? What kind of eyeliner do I use? Do I use a pencil? Do I use a gel? Do I use liquid? You know, like, what does it need to be? Does it need to be waterproof? Does it need to be long wearing? You know, what color? All kinds of stuff, all kinds of questions. And I've tried a bunch of them, and I'm going to show you how I do my eyeliner and then tell you why I choose the eyeliner that I do, because it works best for me. This may not work best for you, but give it a try. Okay, now, eyeliner. My right eye, which is this eye right here, waters a lot. Like, I'm always wiping this eye. So when I apply eyeliner, it needs to be like heavy duty, stay type eyeliner. Like, I don't want it going anywhere. It needs to be like smudge proof. It needs to be waterproof. Because basically when this eye runs and I go like this, I wipe the wing right off and it just doesn't look right when you've got one wing over here and none over here. So I don't know if that's a problem for any of you guys, but it's definitely a problem for me. So liquid eyeliner. One of the reasons I do not use liquid eyeliner is because I wipe it right off. I have bought waterproof, smudge-proof liquid eyeliner, and all of them wipe right off. They just wipe right off. I haven't found one that stays on. It might stay a little bit, but is my eye like waters throughout the day and I'm constantly wiping it. So I needed to find an eyeliner that was gonna stay on my eyes. So liquid eyeliner does not work for me. Might work amazingly for you, does not work for me. And I'm not really that great at it. You know, eyeliner, when you're like doing eyeliner, it is like a precise thing. And I feel like a pencil gives you more room for, you know, grace, less error. And the same thing with a gel. And I feel like you have to press a little bit harder with the pencil or the gel to get the eyeliner on. Whereas a liquid, like, you can just like barely move your hand and just swipe on a stroke that you didn't mean to do. So I don't use liquid eyeliner for that reason. Also, disclaimer, I am not a makeup artist. I'm not. Just a girl, just a mom. I am a blogger. If you want to follow me on Instagram, my Instagram name is @lifesongsofabusymom. And I do like some hair tutorials and I list a lot of my favorite products. And I do list these eyeliners because I know it's a hard thing to find. So I'm going to show you two different eyeliners and they're both gel. One is a pen. It's the push-up liner that is in like a pen that you're gonna use. It looks like this, and I'll tell you about that. And the other one is kind of like in a little gel pot with a brush. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do my left eye with the pen, and I'm gonna do my right eye with the brush gel liner so you can see how it looks. See, my eye's watering right now. So you can see how I do both of them. I figured that was the best way to do things. So another thing, when you're doing your liner, you want to be able to see what you're doing. It's going to be interesting for me to try to do it here on the phone, but I'll do it. But if you can't really see what you're doing, go to Walmart or wherever, go to the dollar store and get like one of these little magnifying mirrors like this. I don't want to blind you, but they're like super power and they've got like little suction cups on the back. Stick it to your mirror and it makes a world of difference. It will, don't look too long because you'll find every like clogged pore and random hair, and it's scary. But get the magnifying mirror. It helps a lot. Another thing that you're probably going to see me do, and a lot of times it's a no-no in the beauty industry, is I am actually going to slightly pull on my skin a little. You're not supposed to do that because it can create wrinkles, but I have to do it. It's the only way I can do it. And also, talking to women who are a little bit older, especially like my mom's age, she's 60, your eyes get, the skin gets more loose as you get older, and eyeliner gets harder to apply because you're like skipping over wrinkles and things like that. So if you are older, you may need to pull a little bit while you're doing it slightly and kind of doing it in small steps instead of one swoop. That's a tip I can give anyone who's a little bit older, because otherwise you can like go over top of it and you miss pieces. It's just a mess. So you may need to pull gently on your skin if you have some mature skin. All right, get to the point, Mandy. Do your eyeliner. Okay. All right, so the first one I'm going to show you is Benefits They're Real. This is a push-up liner. It's going to be backwards. I apologize. But this is what it looks like. It's by Benefit, and it's a push-up liner. This is like 20... Gosh, I don't want to say. Is it 23 or is it like 26? Somewhere around there. It's in the 20s. It does last a long time, though, and it is a waterproof, smudge-proof, long-lasting eyeliner. When you put this on, you have to like scrub it off at night, all right? I have to use like a really good makeup remover to get this stuff off. And that's what I want, because I don't want it going anywhere. So it's definitely a little bit more money, but works really well. So it looks like this. It has an angle, let me see if we can do here. So it's got an angled tip like that, and the gel eyeliner comes right up out of the top, and you use it like a pen. And I'm going to show you how we do that. So I really like that. But I also found one that works just like this, lasts just as long. It might even be slightly better, and it's way less money. And Maybelline makes it, and it's by it's Maybelline New York's Eye Studio. And this is in Black is Black. I always use black eyeliner for winged eyeliner because I feel like all winged eyeliner should be black unless you're doing like funky colors. But so this is the Maybelline Eye Studio, and it's in a little tiny gel pot like this. I think it's like $5 to $7. It's not much money at all, and it comes in this little like pot of gel like this. It also comes with the brush, which is wonderful. It comes with this little teeny tiny brush that you're going to dip in here and use your liner. So it's great. Comes with the brush, it's cheap, and it works really well. So we're gonna do the first one with the pen. This is, again, Benefits They're Real push-up liner. And when you first get this, it'll click when it comes up. Hopefully this is not one of my empty ones, because I haven't been using this in a while. Hopefully I get some up here. If not, I'll have to dig through my drawer and find another one. Here we go. So it's slowly gonna come up where you can see a little bit of it. If you start to get too much liner that pushes up out of the top, sometimes I just take the cap and wipe it, or you can wipe it on, you know, something like a piece of toilet paper or something like that to wipe it. You don't want too much coming out. All right, so we're gonna do this here. Let me see if I can get close enough to you so you can see what I'm doing. All right, what I'm gonna do first is I'm going to draw this line, the wing of it, first. And then I'm going to turn this around and come back the other way. I'm kind of make a little triangle, and I'll show you what I mean here. So another thing, everybody's eye shape is different. All right. And even the shape of this eye to this eye is different. So it's kind of like your eyebrows. They're not twins. They're sisters. Your winged eyeliner is going to be the same way. You're never going to get this one to look identical to this one. It just doesn't happen. This one tends to go down a little bit more, so I have to work things a little bit differently. It's all right. As long as you're getting them as close as you can, it's fine. Really, no one's going to really be able to tell. So let's see if I can get as close as I possibly can here. And I'm going to slightly pull my eye like that. I'm going to start right here at the corner. See the corner? And I'm going to come up in little strokes like that. Up. And it seems really high. Like when you're doing it, you're like, why shouldn't I like come out here? Do not come down out here, or that just looks weird. Don't. You're going to want to go up like that. And you can make little tiny strokes. It doesn't have to be one smooth thing. Don't worry if it's not like a nice clean line. We're gonna fill it all in. All right? So, next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna come back to the tip of this right here, and we're gonna draw a line down to about the middle. It's about the middle of our eye right there. See how there's like a little bit of gap right there? That's fine. We're gonna color that all in. So we're gonna come down to the middle just like that. All right, so yes, Elizabeth, don't make your winged eyelid down like this. You'll look kind of like a clown. All right, so then you're going to fill in this, oops, sorry. You're gonna fill in this section right here. Now, remember, I haven't even gotten the rest of my eye yet. I'm just kind of working on the wing part itself. And another thing I noticed, you are actually almost coming up a bit right here. Let me see if I can show you. Right here, you're in this little section right here. I'm almost bringing the pen up a bit because when you open your eye, it'll make that nice swoop motion like that. So, one second. So just like that, I've got my nice line like this. My kids are being loud, and too much came out right there. That's all right. If it does, just wipe it off. I really should have used a new pen because this one's old. All right, so then I'm going to just come and do the rest of my eye in little strokes. I'm still coming towards my eye from the outside. Like that. And then I'm gonna go the other way in towards, get as tight as I can here where it hits the lash line. And then I might go back here where this top was and just kind of retrace what I've done. And again, this will take practice. See, like right there, I had a little smudge right there. It's all right. It's okay. My kids are being loud. Like that. And I go out a little ways, but I'm not going like too crazy far. You can take it too far, and I've done that too. I've winged my eyeliner out way too far. And even right now, before I put mascara on, it's gonna look like it's too far because my eyelashes aren't up where it almost looks like it's another lash. And I think that's what helps winged eyeliner too, is it makes it look like it's another lash like that. So that's the gel pen on this eye. Don't mind my eyebrows, they need to be fixed. But so that's the gel pen, the Benefits gel pen. So you can see the difference between my eyes with the liner on. And again, this will look much better once the mascara is on. All right, next eye I'm gonna do with this little gel pot thing right here, the Maybelline. So it comes with this little angled brush like this. I got eyeliner all over my hand. So it comes with this little like angled brush. And I'm just going to dip it into here. I'm gonna wipe off the edges, the sides of it, like that. Just so I've got a little bit on my brush. And I'm going to do the same thing. Whoops, sorry. I'm gonna do the same thing over here on this eye. Let's see if you can see this here. Same thing. I'm going to slowly make a line that kind of goes up like that. Same thing that I did with the gel pen. And then same thing, I'm going to come back up and do that little triangle down to the center of my eye. Look how much this eye shakes. But yeah, so I'm going to come back down to the center of my eye like that. Okay, and then I'm gonna fill it in again, just like I did with the pen. Now remember, this is, I'm never like taking something and doing one big swoop. These are teeny tiny little motions, because when you do it in teeny tiny little motions, you can fix more errors and you can fill it in better. It just works better. And same thing, now I'm going to take it towards my eye into the inner corner. And the closer I get to the inner corner, the thinner I want that line to be. Obviously, it's the thickest out here, and it just gradually comes down towards the inner corner of my eye. And then I'm just going to kind of fix this. Hopefully you can see. And just kind of feather it out a little bit. So it looks like that. So there's this side with this gel pen, and then there's this side with the brush. So that's how you do it with the brush. I like both ways. Right now I'm using the brush because I really like the brush and the pot because it's cheaper, way cheaper, and works just as good. So that's the winged eyeliner on both sides, but mascara really helps amplify everything, because I think, you know, that cat eye, that winged eye just kind of opens up your eyes and makes it kind of look like your lashes are up. I'm going to use L'Oreal's telescopic mascara today. This is not a waterproof. I wish they had telescopic and a waterproof, because I love telescopic. I have short lashes, so it's hard for me to get my lashes to look very big. So I really like L'Oreal's telescopic. This is like, this has been around for a long time. So this is black is black. Everything I get is in black around my eyes. If I'm going to use a waterproof, I'm going to use CoverGirl's Supersizer, or the Supersizer. And this is really, really good waterproof. Like, I can cry and wipe my eyes and my mascara doesn't come off. So I really like that. I have tried Thrive's eyeliner, because I'm like, give me an eye, you know, because Thrive was saying how awesome their eyeliner was and that it stayed, but it didn't stay. But I have not tried the mascara yet. So for my mascara, I really like the telescopic. But these are all, I need new products. I should have done this, but all of my stuff is like getting old and dry. And really try to get those outer lashes. I also have weird lashes on this eye. They like curl up. So it's hard for me to kind of straighten them out and make them look long. I do not put any liner on my bottom waterline. I don't, because for me, I feel like it makes my eyes look even smaller. Some people need a little bit of liner on the bottom. That's fine. Some people, you know, will do like a smoky eye and smoke this out and bring liner down here. And that can open it up. For me, it's just, I've got smaller eyes, so it just doesn't work well with me. So I don't use any liner on my bottom lids at all. But I really like the brush. I think that's why I like telescopic so much, is this brush is not like your regular mascara brush. Like, I can't use like those spoolie type mascara brushes. They just don't, they don't separate and lengthen the lashes for me. So that's why I like the telescopic. Also, Blink mascara, B-L-I-N-C, makes really good mascara. It kind of like tubes your lashes. And you can buy a cheaper mascara that does that too, and helps really to lengthen them. But that's usually my problem, is length. And I can apply multiple coats with this where it doesn't get like too crazy clumpy. So yeah, so if you see this, there's like the wing, and then once the lashes are up with it, it looks better and makes more sense to me. So yeah. So do the other one. So let me know if you guys have like really awesome mascara, like Elizabeth was saying, Thrive's really good, or anything else that you love to use and works really well, or an eyeliner that you think is amazing.
comment that below, because that's how, you know, we find all this stuff. You know, people are like, well, how do you learn how to do winged eyeliner? YouTube. Basically what I'm doing with you all now, that's how I learned how to do winged eyeliner. I just watched YouTube videos and learned. And so I'm just kind of sharing what I've learned with y'all. So yeah. But I know this was a weird time of the day today, but I have somewhere that I gotta go tonight, so I figured I would show you my winged eyeliner, because I wear winged eyeliner like every day. It's, if it goes out of style, I'll be in trouble, because I really liked winged eyeliner. It really opens up my eyes, I think, and I just really liked it. I really think it's really classic too, so I like it. But it's not perfect every day. Some days I feel like this is too far, and you know, you just mess with it. Keep practicing. Let me finish up my mascara here. But I need to get more because it's starting to dry out. It's getting very dry. All right, so that's basically it for the winged eyeliner. This is pretty much my everyday makeup. This is how I go out places. Sometimes I'll take a little bit of powder and just go right under my eye, right up along the wing, as you can see, and just kind of smooth that all out. So it takes, if there's any like weird parts to the line or anything like that, it will kind of smooth everything out. Or if you have any fallout from the mascara or your eyeshadow, it kind of helps to take care of that. So yeah, if you have any other questions, please drop them below. I will come back after I'm done with this video and help answer them. I hope that was helpful. Again, this is the winged eyeliner with the gel pen that I use, Benefits They're Real. So that's what that looks like. And this eye right here is with the Maybelline's Eye Studio, this little gel pot that comes with a brush, which is way less expensive. Honestly, if you can't decide between the two, go with the Maybelline. It's cheaper and it works really, really well. So thanks, Elizabeth, so much for having me. I hope this was helpful, guys. Again, if you want to follow me on Instagram, you can follow me at Life Songs of a Busy Mom. And yes, Elizabeth, I'll come back to do some hair tutorials if you want to, or anything else you want to talk about, because I love this kind of stuff. I could watch beauty, hair, fashion tutorials all day long. It's a lot of fun, and I think it should be fun. I think makeup, hair, all of that should be fun, and we should just, you know, play with it and have fun with it and not worry too much about it. All right, guys, I hope you have a wonderful Monday, and I will talk to you soon. Bye.